This is the brand new Lumix LX100 Mark II. Now, to look at it, you might not think much has changed from the Mark I, but this little camera has a huge amount to offer. The LX100 Mark I was already a really nice camera, and the Mark II certainly carries over a lot from its predecessor. So you've still got the same vintage design, still got the control dials along the top, it's still got a really great lens on the front. In fact, generally the ergonomics and the design have all been taken very much from the Mark I, and that's because it was already a really well-designed camera. It's already really nice to hold and to use, and that's certainly carried over here. So in terms of the feel, in terms of the design, not much has changed, but internally, there's a lot of new stuff. So it's a Micro Four Thirds system, but it's actually got a sensor in there that's a little bit bigger than you usually find in a Micro Four Thirds system. So it's using 17 megapixels of a 20 megapixel sensor. But the massive advantage of that is it's gonna give you much better performance when it comes to things like noise, ISO noise certainly, and things like that. It's got this lovely lens on the front, which runs from 24 to 75 millimeters, and that's from an f1.7 to f2.8, which is really great. It gives you a lot of versatility in the kinds of things you can shoot. It's also got this aperture ring around the front there on the lens, which is always a really nice touch and goes hand in hand with things like the dials on the top, which is the exposure compensation and the shutter speed. It's also got a little switch on the top of the lens here, which allows you to just switch between aspect ratios, which is always really handy to be able to do that all on the camera. Now that focal range means it's great for a variety of different types of photography. So you can have it wide at 24 millimeters and you can use it for things like landscape. It's gonna give you those nice wide shots for those. You can use it further in at things like 50 mil or all the way up to 75 mil to get some actually really nice portrait shots. Then you're gonna be able to drop the background out and actually get some really nice portrait shots. The other huge advantage of having the fast aperture is it's gonna be better for lower light conditions, which means you can use it later into the day. Now because of its size, it's also great for things like street and documentary photography, because of the size you can just pop it in your bag, it's lightweight enough to just carry around with you all day, and it means you can just pull it out, it's nice and discreet as well, so you're not going to be up in people's faces with a huge system. It's just a nice little thing to have around with you all day. So it's got a really nice electronic viewfinder, which is great for shooting on a really bright sunny day, but it's also accompanied by the 3-inch LCD touchscreen, which makes it really easy to control your settings. And I've got to say, it's one of the better touchscreens I've used in recent memory. It's very easy to control all of your settings from there, but it also allows you to do things like pick your focus point and change things like that really easily, which is always really handy. It's also got some great features built straight into the camera. So for example, it's got a set of creative filters for you to use. So things like L Monochrome D, which is like a really nice black and white filter, which just looks really great. But it's also got things like a 4K burst mode, which allows you to take 4K photos at 30 frames per second. So if you need to capture an action shot, if you want to make sure you nail it, you can do that. 30 frames a second is definitely, you're gonna get that shot. Definitely. It's also got something called sequence composition, which allows you to take your 4K burst mode. If it's of kind of a scene and you've got movement running through the scene, you can take your burst mode, you can select the frames you want to use, you can composite them together all in camera and create a nice composite of a scene but with movement running throughout. It's also got some amazing other features like post focus, which I always think is actually really incredible. So it takes multiple pictures at the same time of the same thing, and then you can select your focus point in post, which is always just so handy. I mean, if you wanted to change that up later, you could. It's just a really nice tool to have, and that's all in camera again. So all of this is just in camera, which is amazing. You can also quite extensively edit your photos in camera. So without ever having to take them off the camera and put them on the computer, you can do an awful lot with adjusting things like the contrast, the shadows, the highlights, things like that, all in camera, which is always really handy. If you're out and about and you want to edit, if you've been shooting for a couple of hours, you get to a coffee shop, you want to stop, you want to look at your photos, you can start editing them while you're sitting there, which is a really nice thing to have. Now, it's certainly aimed as more of a stills camera, but it does definitely take some really nice video as well. So it'll do 4K video at up to 30 frames a second. It'll do full HD video at up to 60 frames a second. And that's really nice to have in the camera. Now, the reason I say it's more of a stills camera, it doesn't have things like a mic input. Obviously, you could just record the sound on a separate audio recorder, but it's nice that it can do those video things, because if you're out and about and you want to get stuff, then you can. It actually shoots really nice video, but generally it is more of a stills camera. Now, in terms of the actual camera itself, it's really well made. It feels nice in the hands. It is nice and small. So for me, I have big hands. It obviously is going to be a little bit small, but it feels good. It feels solid. It feels rugged. It feels like the kind of thing you could definitely just take around as an everyday camera. Just throw it in your bag and go out. It's perfect for things like travel as well, because obviously it is so small and light. And like I mentioned earlier, things like street photography, documentaries, absolutely perfect. It's also got things like Bluetooth and Wi-Fi built into the camera, which is always helpful. And it charges from a USB cable, which is always just easy because it means you can charge it wherever you go. Ultimately, this is a really lovely camera to use. The images coming out of it are great. The video is great. It's lovely to use because of all the little dials and the kind of vintage feel in that sense. But it does feel nice to hold as well. It's a really versatile little camera because of the 24-75 lens, plus the fact that it's so small and lightweight. You could just have this as a second camera. You could have it as your everyday camera. It's perfect for things like that, for just popping in your bag when you're going out in case you want to use a camera, but you don't want to take your big system. This is ideal. So I hope you found that helpful. If you have any questions at all, pop them down in the comments below. We'll get back to you as soon as we can. If you like the video, make sure to hit the like button. Make sure to subscribe if you're not already. I'll see you in the next video, and as always, thanks for watching.